Small businesses are the heart of the American economy. They're responsible for half of all private sector jobs. And they've created roughly 70% of all new jobs in the past decade.
Well, first of all, small businesses create over two-thirds of all new jobs in America. And if you want your economy to grow, if you want the country to be hopeful, it seems like you ought to be celebrating the talent and energy of our small business owners.
So according to the latest data from the U.S. Census Bureau, small businesses are actually responsible for more than 90% of new jobs in this country. They generate more than half of the GDP and account for half of the private sector workforce.
An entrepreneur flipped on the lights in her tech startup and did her part to add to the more than 8 million new jobs our businesses have created over the past 4 years.
America's small businesses are the engine of job creation. According to the Small Business Administration, small businesses employ almost half of all private sector employees.
And that's small business. It's an engine. It's the most fundamental difference we have in terms of the backbone and strength of our economy.
It isn't in Washington, D.C. It isn't in New York City. The heart of our economy is in small businesses all across this country.
We should start where most new jobs do, in small businesses.
They are called the engine that drives the American economy. Small businesses provide jobs for more than half of the nation's workforce.
Small businesses create 2 out of every 3 jobs in this country, so our recovery depends on them.
Recognizing the fact that those small businesses make up the engine that drives our economy.
We cut taxes for 95% of working families. We cut taxes for small businesses.
So I really grew up believing that small business was at the core.
So small businesses are not only job generators, they're also at the heart of the American dream.
Small businesses are the backbone of the American economy.
Small businesses create most of the new jobs.
I want to be the small business president. I want to really help you.
We need some help.
We genuinely believe that small business is the backbone of America.
Small business is the economic engine of the United States.
Let's also eliminate all capital gains taxes on small business investment.
Small business is the engine of economic growth.
I'm also proposing a new small business tax credit.
Owning a small business is hard.
Small business owners across the country.
Small businesses.
Small businesses.
And all small businesses.
Small business.
And small businesses.
Small business owners.
Small businesses.
Small business.
Small business.
Small business.
Small business.
Small businesses. Small businesses.
Alarming new evidence tonight of widespread fraud in a federal government program designed to give money to small businesses.
The government is dropping the ball on this, allowing huge corporations to grab contracts that are meant for small business.
You see, reports and investigations have been surfacing in the last couple of years that have exposed the inside workings of a fraudulent system.
We discovered hundreds of millions of your tax dollars set aside and meant for small businesses, instead going to huge corporations.
So many government contracts intended for small firms are going instead to some of the biggest corporate names in America.
Billions of dollars in federal contracts meant to help small businesses are actually being awarded to some of the largest corporations in the world.
Do these look like small businesses to you? Or these? Well, they did to the government, which handed out fat contracts that were supposed by law to go to small businesses.
Billions of dollars in government contracts intended for small businesses go instead to large corporations.
You might think that the name Small Business Administration would be a clear description of what that government agency does, support small businesses and make sure that they get a fair share of federal contracts. Well, not quite.
The Small Business Administration recently admitted that billions meant for small businesses have gone to much bigger companies, names from a who's who of corporate America, like aerospace giant Raytheon and tech titans Hewlett-Packard and Oracle.
The result is billions of dollars in losses for those small businesses, the biggest source of jobs in this country, by the way.
Last year, a long list of corporate giants got deals earmarked for the little guys.
Federal investigators say the Small Business Administration awarded contracts to businesses falsely claiming to be located in economically distressed areas. The agency even gave small business contracts to some of the country's biggest companies.
44 large firms were incorrectly listed as small.
And the reason? A classic Washington mix of lax oversight, bad policy, and poor management.
When they see the name Rolls Royce or Microsoft,
if that doesn't ring the bell, if that doesn't tell them that they are large corporations, come on.
The SBA's validation controls failed as three of our four bogus firms were certified.
Fraud, waste, and abuse.
It's not miscoding, it's intentional, and then in many cases, it's outright federal contracting fraud.
As the new head of the Small Business Administration was sworn in today, Democrats on Capitol Hill were suggesting a new name for his agency, maybe something like the Big Business Administration.
U.S. Census Bureau data indicates that there are 28 million small businesses in America and that 98% of all U.S. firms have less than 100 employees. Those small businesses are responsible for over 50% of the gross domestic product, 50% of the private sector workforce, and 90% of U.S. exporters. Most Americans don't realize that the largest economic stimulus plan for the middle class in U.S. history is the Small Business Act. This act requires that the government give a percentage of all federal contracts to small businesses. The Small Business Administration, or SBA, was formed to ensure that this happens. The current small business contracting goal is 23% of the total federal contracts. That's on average. That is supposed to be set aside for small businesses, but in reality, small businesses only get a fraction of that. The majority of the 23% is actually given to some of the world's largest companies and corporations. And all of this is happening with the SBA's knowledge. In 1995, Lloyd Chapman was working for a small IT company in California when he stumbled across this.
It's all my father's fault. He was a contracting officer for the Air Force in Sacramento. And I had gone to work for a little computer company in Northern California, and he was trying to help me. He told me to use the Freedom of Information Act to request the small business subcontracting plans for defense contractors to look for companies that were trying to find small businesses. I was watching television one night, and I saw Lockheed and Northrop had competing airplanes, and then Lockheed had been awarded the contract. And I thought, well, I'll look into that. So he told me how to do a Freedom of Information request. He told me exactly what to say and whatever, and he told me to send it to the procuring contracting officer. They wouldn't give it to me for a while. And he told me that they were supposed to give it to me within 10 days, but it took a lot longer than that. They waited until the contract was really formally awarded. Then they gave it to me, and I got one piece of paper. And back then, the small business goal was 20%, but I want to say that the small business goal was something like 1/100th of 1%. And I thought that they put the decimal point in the wrong place. And so I called the guy up, and he said, nope, that's what it was. And I was confused because my dad told me it was 20, and he'd give me, by the way, copies of the Federal Acquisition Regulation, the FAR. And so I saw it was 20%. And so once I confirmed with the contracting officer at the Air Force that it was, a 10th percent, I thought, well, that's not right. And so I called Barbara Boxer, who was the representative for California at that time. And she put me in touch with Les Aspin, who I think was chair of the House Armed Services Committee. And very quickly, there was a congressional hearing on the contract. And a couple newspapers picked it, the Washington Post picked it up. In fact, I've still got that story. Here's the story from 1992 from the Washington Post by Stephen Perlstein. The title is Lockheed's Minority Small Business Subcontracting Record Faulted. Says the Pentagon's biggest new weapons program, the F-22 stealth fighter, is proving to be as invisible to small and minority-owned defense firms as it is to enemy radar. In a plan approved by the Air Force last summer, Lockheed Corp allocated only $16 million of its $3.2 billion share of the F-22 work to small businesses, about half of 1%. And over here it says, despite the hurdles, Lockheed has offered a fresh proposal that would allocate $517 million to small businesses. I did one FOIA request and maybe made like four phone calls. The Air Force and Lockheed allocated an additional $500 million to small businesses.